And now, the best 60-ish seconds of your week. It's race week, and the race for the Democratic nomination for president is in full stride as former Vice President Joe Biden hits the campaign trail, putting his starting blocks in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, a wise move politically considering the pivotal role that the Keystone State played in 2016 and will again play in 2020. And Vice President Biden got a big boost in the polls as a result of his early campaign. Now he has about a treble lead over both Warren and Bernie Sanders in the Quinnipiac poll just released this week. Pete Buttigieg, the former, I guess, the mayor of South Bend, Indiana, lagging in fourth, although it's really interesting that he's vaulted to that position within a very crowded Democratic field already. The vice president or former vice president brings a lot of advantages to this race, including name identification, a lot of trained operatives, experienced folks, significant support within the establishment of the Democratic Party, but he does not have the endorsement of his former boss, former President Barack Obama. Now, vice presidents who run with the full-throated support of their former boss tend to do pretty well. That's basically how George H.W. Bush got elected in 1988 and how Al Gore came within a whisker in 2000, the closest election in American history. Even Richard Nixon got support from Dwight Eisenhower back in 1960, albeit somewhat reluctant and tepid. But that's a real question for Joe Biden. Has he hit his high watermark? The polls, as we promised last week we discussed, show him with a big lead right now. But will it continue or will it slowly dissipate? That's the big question. I'm betting on this being his high watermark. It doesn't seem to me like there's much upward mobility for Biden at this point, but a lot of potential downslide. So we'll see. And of course, this week, Attorney General William Barr went before a panel of the United States Senate to answer some questions about the Mueller report. And therein you saw a real view of the far left of the Democratic Party. Senator from Hawaii calling the President of the United States of America a quote-unquote grifter and liar. Imagine that kind of rhetoric being used at any other time in recent history. And then Richard Blumenthal from Connecticut, hardly a paragon of virtue, a guy who lied about his military service for crying out loud. I mean, having your ethics questioned by Richard Blumenthal is a little like being called ugly by a toad. But Blumenthal's there taking on Bill Barr, who did a really good job. His ethics have been impeccable and unimpeachable historically. I think the Democrats have a very, very tough case to prosecute against him. And by continuing with the rhetoric that they have used, they do it at their own peril. So also this week, what's going on in Venezuela? We're going to talk a lot more about that next week as the president of Venezuela that the United States backs, Guaido, is basically calling for open insurrection against the incumbent government, a socialist government by extension, and a very corrupt one, which has hurt the people of Venezuela in ways unimaginable. What once was the richest country in South America with tremendous oil reserves and potential for economic growth, squandered and plundered by a socialist, corrupt, oppressive government. So, that's the bad news. The good news is that another race is upon us. It's Derby Day and the greatest 2 minutes in sports as they run for the roses. Unfortunately, the favorite, Omaha Beach, appropriately named since we're celebrating the 75th anniversary of the Normandy invasion, and for me personally, a little bit of historic note, Google order of battle for Omaha Beach. You'll know why. So with the favorite, Omaha Beach, scratched because of some breathing problems, unfortunately, doesn't look like we'll have a run for the Triple Crown this year, as we've had so many of them in recent years after a long drought without. But I'm putting my money on Roadster. Let's see how it goes, namely because of the jockey that will be riding Roadster later this afternoon. So as they run for the roses, take a look, see how we did, make your own pick. Because for now, that is the best 60-ish seconds of your week.